our constitution in that units we are understanding the meaning of constitution and importance of constitution. Constitutions means a set of basic rules followed by a country. It enumerates the organs of the government, its power and functions. There is a reference to the rights and duties of the citizens. The constitution is a reference guide to the government. No one should violate the constitution. Everyone citizen giving respect to our constitution. Our constitution introduction. In this chapter, the meaning, importance, framing and salient features of the constitution are explained. Understanding the preamble of constitution and importance of constitution, salient features of constitution after drafting committee, profile of persons who were involved in drafting committee, and understanding the concept of republic, understanding the needs for strengthening ourselves in adopting the principle of secularism in our daily life, developing the attitude to respect the constitution. These are things we are learning in this unit. First of all, meaning and importance of the constitution. Meaning and importance of the constitution. Constitution means it enumerates the organs of the government, its power and functions. There is a reference to the rights and duties of the citizen. Every citizen will be giving respect to our constitution. No one should violate the constitution. The constitution is the reference guide to the government. Importance of constitution. The constitution is a prominent as it is the fundamental law of the country. Everyone has to adhere to it. All people, including the president, the prime minister, parliamentarians, judges and officers are bound by it. It protects the rights of citizens as well as all are equal before the law. It functions as a reference guide to the duties to the performed. It functions as a reference guide to the duties to be performed by the government. It coordinates the functions of the democratic institutions such as legislature, executive and judiciary. It also organizes better relation between the government and the individuals. The law minister of the Indian Ambedkar, first law minister of the Indian B.R. Ambedkar, on 26 January 1950, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was the law minister of India from August 15, 1947 to 26 January 1950. Drafting committee of the constitution. The constituent assembly prepared the The Constituent Assembly prepared the constitution. Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected as its president when the assembly met for the first time. There were 299 members in the Constituent Assembly. The first session was held on 9th December 1946. Drafting committee. What do you mean by drafting committee? The committee that prepare a draft constitution and place in the Constituent Assembly for discussion and approval. It is telling the drafting committee. The drafting committee, in order to have the process of preparing the constitution, the assembly created various committees. It also created a drafting committee under the chairmanship of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. It was on November 26, 1949, constitution was approved by the Constituent Assembly. The constitution was adopted on January 26, 1950. The constitution declared India as a republic in order to marked as the Republic Day. And it is a national festival on November 26th. Every year the Constitution Day is celebrated, as it was the November 26th, 1949. According to the directive of the Constitution, the first general election of India were held between 1951 to 1952. The Parliament with the Cameral Legislature, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha came into force in 1952. The constitution was adopted on January 26, 1950. On November 26th, every year the Constitution Day is celebrated, as it was on November 26, 1949, the constitution was approved by the Constituent Assembly. The Constitution of India contains 395 articles and 12 schedules. Preamble to the Constitution. The Constitution of India begins with a preamble. The preamble is a considered as the heart of the Constitution, as it represents the dream and ideologies of the people: justice, freedom, equality, self-respect, fraternity and national integrity are the ideologies that find reference in the preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved the constitute India into a socialist, secular, democratic republic and secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individuals and their unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constitution Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, you hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution. in the justice, social, economic and political, these are included. In that, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, the President of the Constitutional Assembly, and Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Chairman of the Drafting Committee, and Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, first Prime Minister of Free India. This is the structure of the Constitution. You can understand easily. Legislative, executive and judiciary. In this legislative, president, parliament coming, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha, upper house and lower house also, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Executive, in that executive, prime minister and the council of ministers, home minister and finance minister, railway minister, these are coming in executive. And judiciary, Supreme Court, after in the down, High Court in the states, High Court every state having, and District Court. This is the structure of the Constitution of India. Next, salient features of the Constitution. Our Constitution has its own unique features. In that first one, written constitution. The Indian constitution is the written form. This is the lengthiest constitution in the world. Lengthiest constitution in the world. The structure, power and extent of power of three organs of government such as legislative, executive and judiciary are explained. Therefore, the size of the constitution is big. Republic. The constitution has declared India as a republic. In the case of republican system, there is no rules of the king. Instead, there is the rule of elected representatives by the people. India, which has this kind of political system, is known as the Democratic Republic. Fundamental rights and duties. This one we are expanded and reading in the next lesson. You have the next unit, that is the fundamental rights and duty. Here shortly I am explaining. The Constitution guarantees six fundamental duties of citizens at present. The state can never pass any law that curbs these fundamental rights. In case of violation of fundamental rights, the judiciary has the power to rectify it. The citizens cannot exercise their rights as per their whims and fancies. The 11 fundamental duties are there in the Constitution. The six fundamental rights and the 11 is the fundamental duties having. Next, fourth one, secularism. It is so important. The Constitution upholds the principle of secularism. The governments are expected to make no discrimination on the basis of religion and are expected to treat all religions equally. To treat all religions equally. The government consider no religion as its religion. Every citizen is at freedom to practice religion of his choice and faith. Independent judiciary. The judiciary is independent of executive and legislature and has a adequate powers. Neither the government nor the parliament can interfere with the function of the judiciary. जुडिशरी में कोई गवर्नमेंट का और कोई भी आदमी इन्वॉल्व नहीं हो सकता है. ऑल आर इक्वल बिफोर द कोर्ट ऑफ लॉ एंड ऑल हैव राइट टू जस्टिस इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ द जुडिशरी. यूनिवर्सल अडल्ट फ्रेंचेस. द सिस्टम ऑफ इलेक्शन रिप्रेजेंटेटिव थ्रू वोटिंग ऑफ अडल्ट मेंबर्स नियर अबाउट 18 ईयर्स above 18 years is called universal adult franchise. All citizens are eligible for voting without any discrimination. Without any discrimination, they must above 18 years old. The constitution wished to establish the welfare state. The state which sets a goal to provide social and economic security to all its citizens is generally known as the welfare state. Election system. India is the largest democracy. What is the democracy? The rule of the people. It is telling democracy. India is the largest democracy in the world. In the past 6 decades, periodic elections have been conducted. The system of democracy has been adequately deep-rooted in our country. It is still a satisfactory system in spite of certain demerits. This is our constitution and silent future of the constitution. Learn, and also we learn the drafting committee and drafting committee chairman of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar and President Rajendra Prasad.